is proof that sons aren't always destined to follow in their father's footsteps, for better or for worse. Zak Ebrahim is the son of a terrorist who broke free from his indoctrination and rejected a path of violence. Now he's a peace advocate and author of The Terrorist's Son. As well, he has a TED Talk with over 4 million views. And Zak joins us now from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Zak, welcome to the show. Thank you so much for being part of our little show. Can you tell us a little bit about your childhood with your father and the radical ideology that he was teaching you?
Sure. Well, my father was not radicalized when he came to the United States from Egypt. In fact, it wasn't until after he moved here. And, you know, even as a young child, I could see a difference taking place in my father. And it basically came in the form of him spending less and less time at home, more time at a particular mosque where the blind Sheikh Omar Abdurrahman, who was involved in the World Trade Center bombing in 1993, often spoke. And so he introduced me to these kinds of men and to the ideology in which they preached, which was essentially that anyone who didn't follow a very narrow idea of what it means to be good was a potential enemy, whether that be other Muslims who disagreed with their interpretation of Islam, or other non-Muslims. And so I was taught to fear people who were very different from me. And it really wasn't until I got older and I began to interact with many of the people I had been taught these stereotypes about that I began to realize that it was a lie.
So, Zak, your father, I mean, Osama bin Laden mentioned him by name, didn't he? So he was fairly high up in the pecking order, so to speak. When was it that you realized what he was trying to show you or teach you was terribly wrong?
The first time I made a Jewish friend, to be honest, I was 16 years old and I began to become close with another young kid, and a few days into our friendship I found out that he was Jewish, and I realized there was no natural animosity between the two of us, that we were not natural enemies as I had been led to believe, and it was the first time really in my life that I thought perhaps what my father had been teaching me was not the truth.
And Zak, from his cell, your father helped to plot the 1993 bombing of the World Trade Center, which killed 6 people and was, I guess, a precursor to the September 11 attacks in 2001. Where were you on September 11, and what did you think when you heard about what had happened?
I was at home in bed, actually, and like many people, I was terrified. You know, when the first plane hit, we still weren't sure that it was an attack, and it became obvious after the second plane hit that this was in fact on purpose. And my first thought, beyond obviously the worry for the people involved, was hoping that it wasn't Muslims who were perpetrating this attack. Unfortunately, I have a lot of experience with really negative experiences because of my father's actions, and I knew that something like this had the potential to really come down very hard on a lot of different kinds of people. And so, you know, of course, I just hope that you know, that it was not members of this this interpretation of Islam that many people have disavowed and have ridiculed, that they were not involved.
And what happened then when you found out that they were, and it was Al-Qaeda and Osama bin Laden?
Well, you know, that's one of the reasons that I started to speak out. I became involved in the anti-war movement in the United States after the invasions of Iraq and Afghanistan, and I saw many instances where people who were protesting with me or counter-protesting across the street could perhaps learn something from my experience. There were a lot of stereotypes about Muslims and about the religion in general that were being perpetuated, you know, by people who didn't necessarily mean to and by others with a specific intent. But I thought if I could show people, one, how I was raised, and that is not the typical way that a Muslim is raised, and that although I was subjected to an ideology that many people are fearful of, that I did not continue to perpetuate that kind of hatred as an adult, and also how I came to choose this path, I believe that there was value in that.
Zak, your TED Talk has been seen by over 4 million people. Have any of the victims' families or the survivors of the terror attacks of 9/11 reached out to you?
I've been very fortunate in my life to get to share my story, and in fact, a portion of the proceeds of my book go to Tuesday's Children, which is a nonprofit organization that began as a support group for the families of victims of 9/11 and eventually grew into a nonprofit organization that supported people who had either been involved, victims of terrorist attacks, or their family members from all over the world. And I've gotten to have some really incredible conversations with family members of victims of 9/11 as well as other attacks, who wanted to do the same thing that I wanted to do, which was share my story and the difficulties that they went through in the hopes that others wouldn't have to go through it as well.
As someone who grew up under radicalisation, you'll probably have some great insight into this. At the moment, there's a big story in Australia, a man called Khaled Sharouf. He has fled to Syria and has joined Islamic State. He's taken his children with him. Mm. His children have been pictured with automatic weapons, holding the heads of severed heads of enemies. The grandmother wants them to come home. Do you think that these children can be de-radicalised and have a normal life back in Australia? Is it too late to save them?
Of course I do. I think that, you know, these children are victims. They are victims of, you know, when my father was teaching me what I was being indoctrinated to believe. You know, a child does not debate with their parents whether what they're being taught is right or wrong. We assume that our parents have our best interests and that what they're teaching us is the truth. And the fact of the matter is, you know, if there was hope for me, certainly there is hope for others. You know, if anything, they need to be taken out of that environment. You know, I was very fortunate in my life that I had the opportunity as I got older to interact with so many of the people that I had been taught such terrible things about. And it was that interaction that brought me out of, you know, my old beliefs.
And Zak, I just can't imagine what it's like to know that your father did such evil things. Do you have any contact with him now at all? And can you imagine ever having contact with him in the future or even forgiving him?
I don't have contact with him now. You know, to be honest, I've forgiven my father for the way his actions affected me. I don't think that it's my place to forgive him for the way he hurt other people. You know, I'm not certain if there's a place or a time where my father and I could have a healthy relationship. You know, I'm not really sure. Time will tell.
Because, Zak, it really was your mother, wasn't it, who helped rescue you and remove your family from your father's influence?
Very much so. In my TED Talk, I talk about a conversation that I had with my mother and how she uttered a very simple phrase to me when I was telling her how my ideals were changing and the friends that I was making and the people that I was interacting with. She very simply said, I'm tired of hating people. And it was very clear from the look on her face the amount of negative energy it takes to be afraid of people that are different from you and to isolate yourself from so much of the world. And I did not want to perpetuate the same hateful beliefs that my father was taught. I was bullied very badly as a young kid in school and unfortunately by an abusive stepfather, but I learned some really amazing lessons about what it's like to be judged for my race or my religion, and I didn't want to make others feel that way.
Sounds like you have an incredible mother. And if you would like to know more of Zak's story, his book, The Terrorist's Son, is out now. Zak Ebrahim, thank you so much for joining us. We do appreciate it.